But you give grace and glory.
Yeah.
You are son and you are shield. No good thing will you withhold from them that walketh up my way. Lord, I thank you that you supplied all I need. All of I need.
Yes, Lord.
Basa glory out of my heart. It's according to your riches, according to your riches in glory through Christ Jesus. Lord, our sufficiency is in you. I can do all things through Christ. I can do all things through Christ. That strengthens us. Hallelujah. We can do all things through Christ that strengthens us. Lord, thank you that you are higher working within us. You are working for us. You are working the will and the ability to do all that you will for us. We give you praise and we give you the glory. In Jesus' name.
Nothing has to happen further. Amen. The time right now
be appropriate, because the thing that's supposed to happen after he comes for the church, amen, could take place, amen, within the next 2 years. Amen. So I just want you to realize that we have a lot to do before Jesus comes. Amen. He's going to come to judge us for all that we have done on the earth. That's the primary issue after the church meets the Lord. Amen. What did you do? And we're going to be judged.
Yes, yes, yes.
Amen. So I want to ask all of you to really begin to pray, not just to come and feel good and get released and get blessed and all of that, but I think that the reason why God is teaching us about his compassion, the same type of compassion that he demonstrates toward us, is the same compassion that we should be demonstrating toward others. Amen. There's no such thing as being able to, amen, to maintain the flow and to stay in God's presence without us, amen, following the example that he has already set. So let's do all that we can to get people, amen, in the presence of the Lord like we are. You know, there are people that we can reach out to, people that we can manage to come to prayer within the body. How many of us reach out, call people and say that, would you meet me in prayer Wednesday? Would you meet me in prayer Monday? Would you meet me in prayer Monday night? Amen. We have to be creative and think about all that we can do to get people in the flow so they can receive what they need to receive. And I think that, you know, we talk about going out and reaching people to bring them in. But revelation of what we can accomplish by going out is contingent upon what we're doing with the people that we have here. So there's a whole lot of people in the church that needs to be reached. How many can understand that?
Yes, it is.
Amen. Encourage people to come to church on Sunday. Amen. Encourage people to come to prayer. Encourage people to come to Bible study. Now, I think that when we get really concerned about and committed to things like this, then we really begin to see how God could use us to go outside of the church and bring people in. So we have to be diligent. Now, I think that all of us can do practical stuff, amen, to build the kingdom of God. And I think it starts right here. If we don't start with the people that we got, you know, call members, amen, and just encourage them to come and pray. Amen. How many can do that? On Sunday, we could have a church full if we would just reach out there, what, call people. But we just want to receive everything we can so we can feel good.
Yes.
Get past our problems.
Yes.
So God can bless us.
Yes.
Amen. Then our vision, amen, is falling real short. So our goal this month, amen, we want to see everybody connected with this ministry we want to send in this church. And we have spouses of members that's not saved. Amen. I think that there's a lot we can do. Amen. If we pray and keep on like we're doing now, will we have the anointing to do it?
Yes. Hallelujah.
Right? Will we have the anointing to do it?
Yes.
Yes.
Amen. So I want you to begin to think about, amen, tonight, if you're back out, if you don't know, sometimes people say, well, I don't know who needs to come. I don't know who I need to call. I don't know who ain't coming. How many know? That's not difficult to fix. Amen. If you're here tonight, I'll try to help you listen. I'll help you listen. A whole lot. You know, this is how you get strong. But scripture says, blessed are the merciful, for they shall what?
Yes.
Obtain mercy. So if you want more mercy, if you want more of God's mercies and goodness and blessings, then we got to be merciful in order what? To obtain more mercy. Is that right? If you want God to do more for you, then what? You just get out and start doing what God told you to do. He'll give you more what? Mercy. Amen.
Yes.
So that's how you get more mercy.
Yes.
More anointing, more joy, more exuberance, and more excitement, and more motivation, more thrill. Amen. You have to give away. Love ain't love until you what? Give it away. That right? Love ain't love unless you what? Give it away. So, amen. And the problem with all of us, after we be saved for years and years, that we usually have a tendency to what? Just get settled in. did not really praise God at that fervent sense. And I think if we can do something about that, we can just what? Start releasing our what? Love. I mean, compassion. Start reaching out. Start with the people here. We don't have to say, well, hey, you know, just a few people be here on Sunday. Sometimes it's a whole lot of, quite a few people. But if nobody called them, it's just going to keep on being like it is. If nobody hook up with them, if nobody encouraged them, amen. And I think all of this is the responsibility of people that are saved. We shouldn't be so short-visioned. We should be able to see the needs of people. How many can see the needs of some of these people in this church?
Yes, thank you, Lord.
Amen. One of the greatest needs is to what? Get them in the flow. Yes. Get them where God can bless them.
Yes.
Get them in prayer. Amen. Am I talking right this morning? Amen. Until we can get involved in that, you know, prayer is not going to be, you know, we can come and try to keep ourselves, you know, above water. But if we want to get really excited in that growth and that, amen, and all that God has for you, it's not going to be released until we give away. Amen. So that's my motivation. I'm giving to y'all. Pour out my heart, amen, amen, and do all that I can to sacrifice and come and pray, amen. And I think that what I'm giving out, I think that you ought to be able to take and receive and do the same and begin to pass it on, begin to reach out, speak into other people's lives and pray for them. Amen. There's a lot of things we can do, amen, to really be expand ourselves and to, amen, get into all that God really wants us to come to. Amen. Let's all just stand this morning. We're just going to close out.
Yes.
Father, make all of us instruments.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, we don't want to just sit here until Jesus comes. Amen. But Lord, we want to pray that we will be able to be led. That we will be able to help people. Not be discouraged after we help and they don't respond. Mm. Lord, we do it all the time. If I stop because people don't respond, I would have stopped a long time ago. Mm. Lord, we keep planting seeds, and we never know when these seeds will germinate.
Yeah.
Help us to look around about us and help us to sow into lives of members, lives of people without. If we can get concerned about members and get them on track,
yeah,
and get them moving forward, and get them concerned about their lives, Lord, I believe that it will prepare us to get people without, people outside of the church, because they will be more challenging than many of those that's in. We can perfect our love on those that's within,
yes,
and reach out, call, and pray, and admonish them, and love on them. Lord, I believe that that will translate to more compassion for those without. Father, we give you praise and the glory. It was to pray the prayer for me. Yeah, the prayer for me. Get me to pray that every day so that we can sympathize with those that don't go the way and those that need our help. Father, we give you praise and the glory in Jesus' name. Now unto him that is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before his presence with exceeding great joy to the only wise God, our Savior. Be glory, honor, dominion, and power, both now and forever. Everybody say, praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.